All right, good afternoon, folks, and welcome to our 43rd council meeting of the 13th elected town council of Happy Valley Goose Bay. This afternoon's meeting is what we classify as an emergency meeting, which falls out of the regular scheduled monthly meetings that we have. Therefore, we've advertised there are two items on the agenda. Two items on the agenda, yes?
Three.
Two items or three? What's the third one? What's that?
Point clerk.
Oh, yeah, well, that would be regular anyway. So before I adopt the agenda of the 43rd meeting, we have to, because our town clerk is away on leave, we have to appoint a town clerk to be able to host a meeting. So I will pass the floor over to the Chair of Finance and Admin.
Thank you, Mayor. Would like to make a motion that in the absence of our CAO for today's meeting, the 43rd meeting of the 13th Council, that we appoint Kathy Eddy, the town's EA, as our town clerk.
Okay, it's moved by Councillor Rumbold, seconded by?
I'll second it.
Okay, seconded by Councillor Pomeroy. Discussion? All those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. I looked at the microphone, Councillor Pomeroy. I thought about you. Good to see you. So all those in favor, contrary minded? Motion's passed, and we've accepted the appointment of Kathy as our town clerk for the meeting. All right, so moving forward, we've got two items on the agenda. They've been advertised. The agenda's in front of you. I'll accept a motion to adopt the agenda as presented.
So moved.
Moved by Councillor Pomeroy, seconded by Councillor Winters. Discussion? Okay, all those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Contrary minded? We've adopted the agenda. Okay, so with that first item, I will pass the floor over to the Chair of Finance and Admin.
Thank you, Mayor. Rumbold. I would like to make a motion I'd like to recommend through the FAP committee that council approve check number 00000266631 in the amount of $5,878 payable to Sean Lee for website development.
Okay, it's been moved by Councillor Rumbold and the FAP committee that we accept the check number, numbers ending in 26631 in the amount of $5,878. Seconded by Councillor Broomfield. Discussion? Councillor Broomfield.
Just wondering, is this up and running on this website? Is it designed?
So my understanding is that the website development has been somewhat completed and is in a beta kind of format. It's being vetted through staff to just check for little bits that might not be correct, and then council will have an opportunity. Is there a time frame for that, Mr. Osmond?
Hopefully in the next week.
Okay, so in the next week or so, council will get a chance to play with the beta version and then make input and changes and comments, and then we'll roll it out live. So I would hope within a month, probably, we should see a new website.
So is this the final payment for him, or is there another one?
It's the full payment up to date. His term is over, but he will be doing more work for us, so there will be more charges down the road.
How far along are we in the process, though? We're almost...
He was on a work term from the College of North Atlantic, so his work term is over now.
Okay.
So we kind of got we are to do some more work.
Okay. And that cost, though, in my opinion, is pittance to what we had budgeted, or have we had previous quotes, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would just add that this seems to be a pretty reasonable amount.
Yeah. So I guess the proof is in the pudding when we get a chance, once staff has a look at it, just to once over if there's any errors in it before it comes to us, so we don't have to do that work. So that's does that answer your question,
yeah,
sir? Any other discussion? Okay, all those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Contrary minded? Motion's passed. I can't wait to see it. All right, the next item is a CPD, Community Planning and Development Committee issue. So I pass the floor over to the chair of that committee, Councillor Broomfield.
Thank you, Your Worship. The Community Planning and Development Committee recommends that council approve the application from Gary Catalan Holdings for the following variances, subject to compliance with all the town's development regulations and conditions. The variance 7A Justin at 3.3% lot frontage, 7B Justin at 10% lot frontage. 9 Justin, 6.67% frontage. 11 Justin, total 7.86%, 3.3% lot frontage, and 4.53% lot area.
Okay, so I see there's two here, number four. Are these both separate? Are these both separate motions, Mr. Tillon? Or is it just continued on?
They're both number four.
Yeah, that's why I'm...
Yeah, that's just one motion, Your Honor.
Okay, so continue on with your recommendation. Okay.
Now, the Community Planning and Development Committee recommends that Council approve and provide an approval in principle for the application from Gary Kelly Holdings for a 4-by-single-story fourplex seniors housing, one per lot, located at 7A, 7B, 9, and 11 Justin Avenue, with the following conditions: compliance with all the town's development regulations, with special reference to section 3.2.1, residential mixed multi-unit, and section 5.6.11, plex housing, and the stormwater detention policy. B, applicant obtains all required approvals from Service NL or any government agencies having jurisdiction. And C, applicant to acquire all required building permits complete with design. Design to include fence for added privacy and security for neighbors.
Okay, so it's been moved by Councilor Broomfield and the CPD committee that Council approve the application for Gary Callahan Holdings for the variances that were noted, and also recommends Council provide approval in principle for the application from Gary Callahan's Holdings for the indicated development on 7A and B Justin, 9 and 11 Justin Avenue. And of course, they're with all the regular development regulation that have been identified. Seconded by?
I'll second.
Okay, seconded by Councillor Compton-Hobbs. Discussion?
Just wanted to add.
Councillor Compton-Hobbs.
Oh, sorry. Just wanted to say that's good to see this application coming forward, that senior housing is such a big demand in the community, and hopefully he's very successful with his units.
Yep. Again, you know, it's 16 additional seniors housing units that we'll see. I totally support the notes or the information that Councillor Compton-Hobbs just said. So, you know, we've put our support behind 16, 20. This will be 34 units in the last short order, including rapid housing and the recent Newfoundland Labrador housing. So that's a huge, huge thing. So I think that's, I think it's important. So any other discussion? Okay, none being heard. All those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Contrary minded? Motion is passed. And as it is an emergent meeting, we've advertised the two items. That's the only two items that can come to the agenda. So I will entertain a motion to adjourn. I always look at Councillor Rumbold because the adjournment is a different process. Motion made by Councillor Compton-Hobbs, seconded by Councillor Rumbold. Discussion? All those in favor indicate with aye.
Aye.
Aye. Contrary minded? The meeting is adjourned. Thank you, folks.